Now, for my next guest, is you may have seen in the world of YouTube. He is an internet sensation and also the self-proclaimed CEO of Sega. So let's please give it up for Keith Apicary. We'll need her back, Keith.
What?
We will need her back.
Oh, I'll put you away now. Sorry, I thought it was going well back there when you're talking to the lieutenant.
Okay, thank you very much. All right, my next guest, God. All right, Keith, come on up,
I'm single again.
Hello. Have a seat. Have a seat. Apparently a lot less gravity in this room.
He's good. Well, nice.
Our rival is the original NBA Jam.
That game parties hard. I love that game. Pulling people's pants down. That doesn't happen in the real NBA. I wish I took note of your artistry.
We did what we could. Thank you.
You did a lot of good things. I love your game. Rampage, your game freaking ruled. You smashed stuff. It's awesome. Right?
Welcome to the show.
Well, thanks for having me and my faith. I'm glad to be here. Welcome to looking at me.
Hey, relax. You seem so tense.
Well, your girlfriend back there, oh, wow. She was whispering in my ear.
Well, welcome to the East Coast. So, tell me, what do you think of Free Play Florida?
I love it. It's awesome. I so far haven't paid anything, so they're living up to their title. Everything's free. Great. Everyone charge everything to room 122 on your receipts.
It's Brian's room.
He'll pick up the tab. It's awesome. I play a lot of games. I'm mashing buttons, chugging all kinds of gigabytes. It's great. I love it.
Awesome. Well, now, have you seen any games in the showroom that you'd like to take home?
Yeah. There's a game, I don't know what the heck it is. It's like a big birdhouse or something. That was tight, because I couldn't figure out what the heck I was looking at. And it was not very often that you see an arcade game you've never seen before. Does anyone know the game I'm talking about?
Is that
the Exterminator game?
It's a prototype, yeah.
That's why I've never seen it. I'm like, I freaking know stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Like, recently? In a spare time or something? Yeah, actually, I've never seen it before. I feel like you just did it yesterday. And you wrote it. Okay, cool. So I'm not a complete moron. Don't judge my appearance. Judge my mouth.
You don't even need me. You just wind them up and you know.
Verbal diary.
I'm just going to sit back and watch.
All
right. I've heard that you have a pretty good collection of games yourself.
I sure do.
So, are there any gems in there that you would like to tell us?
Duh, everything I own. I have so many modified DMGs in my house, I could make a bed out of them. I have a Game Boy store kiosk, super tight. I have an original custom, does not exist anywhere besides my domain. A Streets of Rage arcade cabinet, I know, it's tight. I have an F-Zero AX deluxe cabinet with a full motion seat, so cool. Blue Falcon, I think I would love to see you and Blue Falcon go at it in an alley somewhere. That would be amazing. Captain Falcon, I should say.
Actually, Blue Falcon's a poker buddy.
Well, what's the name of your ship?
So, the Phantom Cruiser.
The Phantom Cruiser and the Blue Falcon need to have a drag race. That would be amazing. Captain Falcon is a very similar masculine male like yourself. You should Google him. He's tight. His spaceship is in my house right now. I got all kinds of stuff. I got a Geometry Wars cabinet. I got a Mario World pinball machine. I have a vending machine with like all kinds of stuff in it. 7-Up machine from the 90s.
I'm afraid to ask what it vends.
It's just got like cowtails and Hershey's Snickers bars and, you know, the usual. I did put a loose sandwich in there one time. And so I wanted to have like a meal. My friends were coming over to watch Royal Rumble, and I feel like I needed to cater to them. It's basically my pantry. It's just a vending machine. It doesn't cost anything. It's free. I got it for $300 off Craigslist, and at the same time, I got a 7-Up machine from the 90s off Craigslist. Like, from the same dude. He's like, ah, just take care. It's like, this is what the guy ate out of, was a vending machine.
So was the sandwich wrapped, or was it loose? Would you start to fall down and reassemble at the bottom?
Yeah, like it when my friend selected sandwich, it fell and peanut butter got all over the glass. So it opened up, so it was a bad idea. So don't put loose sandwiches in vending machines, it doesn't work. And no one's gonna buy it anyways, it's just gonna go stale. And then I also put a loose cup of Sunny Delight in there. That was a bad idea. That was stupid. But I never owned a vending machine, I didn't know how to play it. So I'm used to like video games, not mother caregiving and feeding people, you know. I'm not a caterer.
Okay.
Because chaos. I chug gigabytes. Yeah.
Alrighty. So, well, clearly you are a lover of video games.
Oh man, you have no idea. So, you can see me in my underwear surrounded by video games all over the internet. That's it. I should stop talking right now. I'm exposing too much about my sad personal life.
Stays on the show.
Okay, good.
So what was the first video game console you ever experienced, and do you remember which games you wound up playing?
I sure do. You have opened the wormhole.
Stand back, everybody.
The first game I played, Atari 2600 was the first thing I ever played, and I played Joust was the very first game I ever played on Atari 2600. That was amazing. I got really good at it. Then I played Asteroids. We had Frogger on there. And that's all I really remember was playing Asteroids and Joust and stuff. But then after that,
I play Asteroids, but mine's more the live version. We had to go through an asteroid belt just to get here tonight.
So I have to learn a few tricks from you. Your joystick's probably a lot bigger and more powerful than mine is. Mine's that skinny and shiny.
Hey, I walked into that.
I only have one little round thing below it. I'm stretching on this one.
Back to your first video game. So your first video game. So you played Asteroids. You played what else?
I don't remember because my memory has been erased ever since I got the system of systems, the console king, the Sega Genesis. That I went from Atari 2600 to Genesis. And that blew my mind. That was like, whoa, I got blast processed and I never came back. So I love Sega Genesis. Best system ever. So yeah, I mostly still only play Genesis and Neo Geo. Those are like my go-to. Like, I'm a bad boy and I like partying in the street. And you know, those are the kind of systems for like drug dealers. You know, like, someone who's like, don't mess with him. Why? He plays Neo Geo. And guys who like, no sleeves, you know. That's the kind of stuff I mess around with. I don't mess around with 2600 anymore. Nintendo. Not into it. I mean, come on, look, I'm a bad boy.
And?
Oh, you want to know more games I have? Why stop now? I told them back there, I was like, oh, I'm going to be quick. I don't want to bore everyone. What time it is now, but... We're just getting started.
Lip is getting a second wind.
I woke up. I had a Jolly Ranger. Blue. Great flavor.
Now, Keith, in addition to being the self-proclaimed CEO of Sega,
guilty,
you also have appeared in a number of music videos.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
In which you sing and dance.
Now, yeah, how did
you
that?
Discover... How did you discover these hidden talents?
They're still hidden. They're down deep. I don't know how I pull them out of the depths of my body. I don't think I know how to dance, to be honest. I think I know how to rhythmically convulse. I spaz to the beat, I guess. And I don't know. Oh, thank you. I love you too, mystery man. Keeping Tom in here. What are you doing? Oh, it's Jonathan. He was in my panel. He tried to outdance, speaking of dancing, he tried to outdance me. Failed miserably. Yeah, I just like to dance. Space Channel 5 opened up my world. Ooh la la. Literally.
So what kind of music do you usually sing and dance to?
I really like chiptunes, you know. I don't know if anyone's at 10 o'clock tonight. Later on, Boy Without Batteries is playing. He's a chiptune artist. He's a cool dude. I really like Phantom NK, one of the best chiptune artists in the entire world. He's from Sweden. Handsome, young, strapping man who knows how to manipulate a motherboard. I just like chiptunes. I like French pop music.
French pop music.
Yeah, you ever heard the band Yell?
Yeah.
They're great. I like them. They really get you moving. I like dance music. The things I can move to.
Ah, I see.
Yeah.
I see. Yes, in fact, actually, you've done some music videos with Yell.
Yeah,
with Yell and also with WWE wrestler Dolph Ziggler. Tell us about that.
Yeah, we weren't dancing. I was trying to get him into dancing with me, but he was too afraid. You know what happened with
dancing or
no? Well, physically manipulating his body. You could call it pain dancing or something. I don't know, destroying him with grace, killing him with grace is what I would do. Yeah, I got a little feud with Dolph Ziggler because he really bothered me. He just had a big ego and I didn't like it. So I called him out on it and then he came right back and said better things about me that weren't real cool. And I had said more about him. And then we had this whole feud and this thing turned bananas and went crazy. And we still haven't fought, but it's all right. Whatever.
So is this something we can look forward to in the future?
I think it will happen eventually. It will definitely happen. Vincent McMahon.
Total SmackDown?
Yeah, I think it could happen. Okay. SmackDown Live, maybe, or Raw Monday Night Raw. I don't know. It would be amazing. I was technically on Monday Night Raw because in the very corner of the screen one night, they were like, check out Dolph Ziggler's YouTube channel. And in the little clip they were showing was me falling off of my 10-foot bunk bed onto a kitchen table, breaking a bunch of glasses, because in that video he used my clip. What is happening here? He's saying, keep talking.
So, well, you've obviously caught his interest, so.
Yes.
So, he loves wrestling. He watches it all the time.
Nice. Me too.
Like, he was like, I remember, dude.
Yeah, he watched. He must have watched Monday Night Raw and saw me in the corner of the screen. You know. Yeah. Anyways.
So now I understand that you also done videos with Kimberly Cole. Tell us about that.
Yeah, that was a thing where like,
okay,
maybe not.
maybe we'll just let that one stay private.
That was like a weird experience. Has anyone ever seen the dance audition video that I did? If you haven't seen it, just search me, Keith Apicary. Dance audition. What happened had been was Kimberly Cole, was having an audition for professional dancers out in Los Angeles, California. So I was living with Socket, Rhode Island, and what's the big deal? He doesn't want to be near me? What? You want to be near me? You don't want to be near me? Okay, I don't know what he was saying to me. No, speak ignorance. Sorry, my so I went and auditioned for this dance video, and I thought I was tearing it up. And all these people were not having it, because they were like cool and had like cool body shapes and stuff, and were doing all these physical maneuvers to the music. And I did what I did, and then I got in the music video because of it, because I guess I stood out. But it was probably, I was giving out Capri Suns to everyone, because I wanted to make sure everyone was staying hydrated. And I brought like bag lunches and stuff, and I was just like, concerned about everybody. So I think they were just like, oh, he's really nice. Yeah, we should like put him in the music video, because he basically got free lunch for everybody. That's probably why they put me in the video. And I could do some moves and stuff, so whatever. Yeah.
Okay.
That was trying to avoid this long rant, because if you ask me something, I can't just say it. I gotta like have you live it with me.
Yeah. All right, sir. Yeah. So the French singer, Yao?
Yeah.
Yeah. Tell us about that experience.
She's like a babe from France. I'm a red-blooded man from America. So I just introduced my body maneuvers to her, and she's like, I like what you can do. And then we've made some videos together since. I basically just auditioned my abilities, and she was down with it. So we've done some dance videos together. There's a new video coming out in like a week with us. That'll be cool. It's for a French phrase that I can't say because I don't know how to speak French, but it'll be cool, so you can watch that.
And then you're really sick with it?
No, I'm just in it as like visual pleasure. And that's what they paid me for. So that she's there for like the audible pleasure, and she's really good looking too. That doesn't hurt, but you're not really noticing when you see my advanced hairstyle on the screen.
So what music videos did you actually sing?
Oh, those are all my music videos for like my songs. I have like all my own songs. That
you write all your own songs?
Sure do.
For a song?
Yeah, my tongue manipulates the microphone. Like you wouldn't believe. I have a song called Four Red Buttons and Two Joysticks. It's about the Neo Geo. I have a song called Sonic the Hedge Song. It's about Sonic the Hedgehog. Koopa Bounce.
You know, Jay's back on the ship is a big Sonic fan. He's listening in by radio. Could you hit us with a line or two from the Sonic the Hedgehog?
Oh yeah, sure. Let's see here. The chorus is like S-O-N-S-E-T-H-A. Wait, I don't know how to do it with the music. This is gonna be strange. I've never done it. Here's like a little chorus. Sean, I'm gonna give you like a don't record this and try to make millions off of it and then put it on the internet and bootleg my voice here. Sonic is the best there is. 16 bits of some serious bliss. That's like one line. It's everybody, give it up for Keith Apicary. It sounds like 0.5% better with music behind it.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah.
But thank you so much for sharing that with us. Thank you for this. And thank you for being on the show today.
Well, it sounds like you're done with me. We do
have a schedule.
All right.
But this has been a little
bit until the guest is here to tell the safety sheet. I don't want to make it look like there's no one up here. So. Trying to get my money's worth out of this scene.
So, well, you're welcome to hang out with us while we carry on and move on to our next guest.
All right.
So
that looks expensive.
Okay, once again, thank you.
Just moving the target.
Okay. All right, ladies and gentlemen, moving right along.